this is Tashara. I'm with the guys from Almost Monday. Welcome to Newcastle.
Thank you so much. Thanks, man.
How was your journey?
Yeah, it's good. We played in Manchester last night, which was great, and looking forward to Newcastle. Stoked to be in the UK.
So getting the call from the driver era to ask you to join them on tour, how did that feel like, getting that invite?
Yeah, well, number one, they've become great friends. So first feelings was just excitement to just hang out and be friends. And then on top of that, they have, like, I think one of the best fan bases in the whole world. Just such giving fans. So to be able to hang out with your buds and also be in front of such giving fans every night, it's truly just always the best.
What have been some of the most beautiful moments so far on tour?
I mean,
Bristol for us, surprisingly. We had because we've been doing Europe and all these places, and we just found Bristol to be so. We had an amazing off day. But it's, you know, again, the fans are just so great everywhere. Like, everywhere we've gone, it just seems like they're so giving. But yeah, we had a pretty nice time in Bristol. Edinburgh was pretty nice as well.
Is there any particular songs that the new fans especially have really resonated with the most?
I think there's a song that's on the new record called You Look So Good. And people can kind of sing along after hearing it once, which is always kind of a cool thing. And song we played live before it was out, and playing it live and seeing people reaction really influenced us to put it on the record.
Brilliant. So if you were to describe your journey through 2024 so far, what have been some of those standout moments for you as a trio?
So you just go back to...
Well, we just put out the album, so that's a pretty big moment. We just did some pretty big venues in the States. We were just doing some arenas, so you have to do Madison Square Garden and the Forum, so they have some pretty special places to play. Maybe some festivals and stuff like that too.
So when you are working on something as special as an album, what kind of elements of Almost Monday do you want to include in that?
Yeah, I think what felt important, well, feels important for us as Almost Monday is always coming back to being yourself is just always the best option, because it just, people can really feel and feel it from you. So I think who we are to our core is pretty joyful people. Maybe it doesn't seem like it. Maybe we're a little tired, run down from the three shows in a row. But I promise we usually are maybe a little bit more smiley. But I think down to who we are, we're pretty joyful people. And I think for us, tapping into that and tapping into the music being feel good and something that at the end of the day, we just would want people to come to a gig and have a great time. And be able to dance with their friends and just have an amazing night. That's kind of always been the goal thus far with Almost Monday. So that was kind of the approach, I think, from the 30,000 feet perspective of the album, was to just make something that felt like us and felt like an invitation for people to just come to a show and have a great time. So
for you, kind of related to that, what is the art of being truly joyful?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think being present for me personally has been a huge one to that. Not getting too in your head of what's next or what's behind you, but truly enjoying the present as a gift. That always does the trick for me to just being grateful and joyful to be here.
Good. Austin, how about the rest of you guys?
Yeah, that's actually, I was going to say, being present as well. And I think to have the mindset of you can make most situations work for you, even if it's a rough situation, you can look to your left and your right and find somebody that you're doing it with, and you're going to have a laugh about how shitty something is or whatever, and that you can make a lot of things better that way. So finding a way to be content in the moment and being present goes with it.
Awesome. And yourself?
Just being grateful for like what we do, like we're, you know, getting to travel the world and play our music to people. So it's just, I think we're always remembering that it's special. So yeah, we take it for granted.
It's a great question, but I'm glad that you brought that in. I know that we don't look like the joyful almost Monday. I really feel that.
And sleep.
And sleep. That takes you out of the present. It puts you in a very weird place, Rishabh. But yeah, that's a great question. I loved it.
Now, with it being the month of Halloween, are you more of a trick or a treat kind of guy?
That's good too. I like a good treat. Yeah, I like my treats. I like a good treat. What is the trick part of it? Like, what is that attached to? Like, is it, do you trick people? Like, because it's a thing. Does anybody know?
Depends on the context.
That's something we need to find out.
Right, yeah. Are you just like, yeah. But treat is nice.
Good one. So if Almost Monday were a cocktail, what would be it?
Tequila.
Tequila, that's true, yeah.
Tequila.
I was going to say Aperol Spritz. Just a sunny drink.
Oh, we'll have a couple. You know, it's a whole bar menu.
Yeah, definitely.
I think some type of citrus. or a passion fruit, like a passion fruit margarita or something.
I kind of like that, bro. I'm with you there. We spent time in Italy last year, and that was an amazing Aperol Spritz in Italy. It was like, very easy to be joyful in that situation.
Yeah. Awesome. So, like, when you think about the record itself and making it, how do you feel it tested you, but in a beautiful way?
Similar with the question. So, try not. I think we have been writing with our producer Simon since kind of day one. We've always joked he's kind of like been the fourth secret member of the band. And I think over time, when you work with the same people over and over, like we've written quite literally like hundreds of songs, you're sort of like looking for new ways to be inspired and new ways to push each other. And I think, I do think we did have to reach like deep on the end, you know, trying to finish this album, because we had some songs that we felt were good, and then we felt like there's two or three that aren't there. And then we just kind of got in this weird place of like writing just songs that we didn't feel were good enough.
Yes.
So I think like, oddly enough, I think it was like we took some time away from the studio because we'd be in there so much. Yes. And just felt, and I think that time in a weird way like helped us just like go, maybe have real life experience. And then when you're back in the studio, you're sort of like, oh, I'm juiced to like say something now, you know? So that helped us like kind of get past what felt like a little rough patch of finishing the record, was to just kind of like, okay, just take a second, go home to San Diego, get a different thing, play some shows, play some gigs, and then come back. And that helped us finish it. So,
and I guess I kind of related to that. How do you make sure that either tour fatigue or even studio fatigue doesn't get too overwhelming?
Yeah, they're both very real, tour and studio. Like, it's funny, I feel like every time you're in the studio, you're like, I just like missed the road. It's so fun to just play these tunes. And then when you're out here, you're like, I'd be sick to be in the studio and like be creative. So it's funny. But I think we've been doing a lot of touring this year, and I think it's just all about, on the touring end of it, in my opinion, it's like attaching it more to the people that are coming. For some people, it's their first concert ever.
Yeah.
And then, you know, it's somebody's last, you know, so attaching it to something that's bigger than just you. Like, it's about these people having a good time. And that always helps, at least me, like, keep going and feel excited about a gig. And then the studio, I think it's just getting out and just having more, like I said, experiences to help you just say something, you know, that feels that it can be relatable. So,
given that, like, nights like these, like you said, can be somebody's first ever gig or experience of live music, how does it feel knowing that you are part of that memory?
Yeah, it's a great feeling. We had a lot of that on the tour where in the U.S. there was, like, a lot of younger fans on that tour, and to, like, be somebody's first concert and, like, hear that, it's like,
fucking went.
That's cool. I hope you liked it. I hope we started it. You know, I hope you were like, oh man, like, what is this whole live show thing? I hope it's, I want to keep going with this, but it is, I guess, just an honor.
Good. Can you remember what your first live music experiences were, the very first shows you attended as young movie music fans?
Yeah. I feel like I know both of yours, which is Sippo Chapanzo.
It was this band called Four Today, and it was a hardcore show.
Selma?
At Soma. Yeah. Any other details you remember?
You have fun.
Yeah, a mosh pit or something.
Close.
You did have fun.
There was mosh pit, and I was just trying not to get destroyed, so I would like I got slammed against the subs trying to avoid it. But it was awesome. It was it was the first time that I experienced energy like that in a room,
yeah.
And it made me want to be a part of it in some ways.
Good. And yourself?
I'm always like, it's hard for me to remember like the first concert, but kind of similarly, I remember seeing our friend's band. They were called O Vanquished Foe at this place called the Echo, or not the Echoplex. What was that venue in Escondido? It's not there anymore, but anyway, it was just this like dingy little venue. But that's like the first, and it was another kind of hardcore band in San Diego. And I just remember being like, big kids. Like, I don't know. I just remember that's good. But yeah, our buddy O Vanquished Foe. The boys.
I had a family friend who managed Blink-182, so I was going on my first few concerts when I was really young. I don't even really remember, but yeah. It was Blink-182 with No Doubt opening, allegedly. Probably young. I don't even remember the show, but the one that probably impacted me the most that I was like that I can actually remember when I was really young was going to see AC/DC and. Watching Angus Young, and I was just like, oh, shit. Oh, this was, like, before I played guitar and stuff.
Going in as the defense.
Yeah. Yeah. It just made me, like, really... And just want to pick up guitar, so...
Awesome. So, in terms of the rest of this year and how you would like to end it in style and welcoming 2025 in even more style, what are your plans?
Cool.
Well... The
things you can't say.
Yeah. Well, we just released some dates in Asia that we were going to go do, which is really exciting, and that will be a headline run. And for some reason, it's our biggest market. We're going to do a big room there for us, and that's really exciting. And we'll be gearing up for some more touring next year and some more things to be announced. So more of the same, but hopefully just getting a little better at it.
Awesome. Do you feel right now you've had your coming of age moment, or are you still finding your wings?
Mm-hmm. I feel like the wings just get a little bigger, you know, and you're able to go a little farther and a little higher, but it's just fun to keep going up. And I hope all this week continue to learn and grow. I think it keeps things interesting.
Cool. And to all those Almost Monday fans that have supported you this far, What would you like to say to them?
Yeah, just a lot of gratitude. I mean, if you really, really get down into it, I mean, they're the reason why we get to do this, which is the ultimate thank you. I hope you guys have liked the album, and a lot more music on the way and a lot more touring on the way.
Awesome. Sounds good. And one final question.
Yeah.
In terms of tonight's set, what are Almost Monday gonna bring to the party?
we're gonna scrape every bit of energy we have and go out there and blow it up for the boys.
Awesome. Well, I wish you all the best, and hopefully see you back here soon.
Yes, thank you so much. Thank you.